Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Endata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. You know, Amazon Echo or Alexa is a super popular device these days. It has all kinds of uses for folks with disabilities. Craig Burns on our mobility and cognition team is going to show us how to use an alternative and augmentative communication device to access Amazon Echo.
Hi, I'm Craig, Assistive Technology Specialist here at Easter Seals Crossroads. One of the often necessary, or at least often requested, items that goes along with augmentative communication devices is electronic aids to daily living, also known as EADLs or ECUs, environmental control units. With the arrival of products like the Amazon Echo, the Echo Dot, and the Google Home, AAC users may be able to take advantage of some of the features of these products to incorporate many of these EADLs into their devices and into their lives. Using an AAC app on this iPad or any other dedicated device, regardless of access method, Alexa, for example, will help us control our environment. Here are some examples. On this app, I can go to Favorites.
Alexa, what is the temperature today?
In Indianapolis, it's 39 degrees with cloudy skies. Today, you can look for showers with a high of 47 degrees and a low of 30 degrees.
Alexa, turn on the light.
Okay.
Alexa, play jazz.
The piano bar from Spotify.
So you can see, just using the app and some saved messages, we can control the Echo to do what we want.
Alexa, stop.
That app was verbally, so we can use Assistive Express or any other AAC app that you might use. Might be your favorite app on your iPad or on your dedicated device.
So there's a different way to get Alexa's attention and get things done around the house. That's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Endata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.